Howdy, howdy. Sioux Devil here, and welcome to a very interesting video. I had a great comment, and I make so many videos because of comments, and this may be one of the best. It was just a question. Captain Beardy was asking about miners. Miners are just so weak, and they're not very good on the front lines, and he watched one of the videos that we did on the testing with the bottom. The infantry under for 400 gold and under, and he asked the question. He said, "Is it possible that miners sort of have a conflicting role, where they're more intended to be like the Dowie version of spearmen, or even halberdiers? Is that what's happening? And because miners, we have miners with blasting charges, and blasting charges are so good against infantry. Is there a chance that they're do have this role, and they're really meant to be the cheap version of anti-cavalry?" And what he noted is that cavalry actually has very low melee defense. A lot of them do. So if we look at Empire Knights, they have 28 melee defense. They have a ton of armor, 110 armor. Would they be good? And he asked, did I have any data on that? And I have a little bit of data on cavalry, but not against miners. I mean, when I think of anti-cav for the Dowie, I mean, of course, I think of, or anti-large, I think of bolt throwers, cannons, gyrocopters with brimstone guns, iron drakes, even rangers with great weapons. Thunderers would do a pretty damn good job against cav. Of course, I think of slayers. Dragonback Slayers and now Giant Slayers. I do not think of miners, nor have I ever. So I thought, let's do some testing. So we'll get here, our Empire Knights at 850, and let's just see, we're on Glacial Lake, so we can do some quick tests. And they're at 850. I'll grab a couple miners. And this isn't the perfect test, and I'm not going to have a lot of data this go around. I just wanted to show everybody because I think this is just, my mind just sort of went. All right, so we'll get the Empire Knights up against two miners. Are miners the Dowie version of cheap anti-cav? Well, they're certainly armor piercing. Cav certainly has low melee defense. Can these two miners at 650 gold do anything against these cav? Now, I understand this is not a person. Okay, this is not a human player that's controlling this cav, and that makes a big difference. But let's just see how this works out. So they go into the miners. Our miners will come into the side. I'm not going to control anything or try and get the best angle from my miners. I'm just going to let them fight. But you can see already, these miners are starting to take some health off of those Empire Knights. Now they've got the green cross, which says they're winning. These Empire Knights are starting to get winded. The miners are also winded, but they're getting that green cross. And they're really taking a chunk out of these knights. They're chasing them around the map, which you actually could do. I mean, that's one of the advantages of miners at 325 gold. You get two groups of miners, it's fire and forget. You just let them chase those Empire Knights all the way around the field. It doesn't matter to you if they get wiped out by another group of cav. But look at this. These Empire Knights are getting eaten alive. Yeah, they're killing some miners. They got 44 kills, but these miners both have green crosses, which say they think they're winning, and they're just pushing these Empire Knights all over the field. And there they go. 55 minutes. They've won. And the Empire Knights have 51 kills. The miners, 2200, 2298 versus 5700, they probably have 40% of their health left, let's say. All right, 40% of their health. So that's pretty much the best case scenario you can have, right? The Empire Knights are not armor piercing. The miners are armor piercing, but the miners don't have charge defense or anything like that. So I thought, why don't we test our much maligned Longbeards with great weapons at 750 gold versus these Empire Knights at 850? And these Longbeards with great weapons, I'm not. I know they have charge defense against large, but I'm not going to do. I'm just going to run them in, let the fight go, see what happens. Let's see if the Longbeards with great weapons are really not meant to be an infantry, a frontline infantry unit. They're more like a hybrid between spears and halberds. All right, well, we'll get that fight going. Get them in there. And, well, I think they're winning already. They'll chase him down. They're definitely taking more health. And they took the charge. They didn't use their charge defense against large or anything like that. And how many kills? These guys got 5 kills. These Empire Knights, I'm sure they're going to get some more on this charge right here. All right. And they're just taking it to them. These Longbeards. Just taking it to these guys. And are they going to get another charge? No, they're gone. How many kills? They got 11 kills. Now let's remember that number. They got 11 kills. And these guys at 33 versus 64, they have more than half health for our Longbeards with great weapons. More than half health. All right. 11 kills for the Empire Knights. More than half health for our Longbeards with great weapons. So let's go grab a true anti-large Dowie unit. You all know who I'm grabbing. I'm going to grab some Slayers. They're at 900 gold, even more expensive than the 750 gold and 650 of the two Miners. Let's grab them. Let's put them up against the Empire Knights. This is the Dowie anti-large. They have an incredible anti-large bonus, huge weapon strength, unbreakable, very fast. You know, what's their anti-large bonus is, what, 24, which is ridiculous. So let's see how these guys do. All right, here we go. And, well, they're losing quite a bit of health. I'd say it's about even health right now. Now the Slayers are winning. They're doing pretty good. And the Empire Knights are gone. But look at this. The Empire Knights have killed 22 instead of 11. And these Slayers are at 2,300 health instead of, you know, that's, was it 3,300 for the Longbeards with great weapons? That's crazy. I mean, that is literally incredible. The Longbeards with great weapons did better than the Slayers. Okay, that's saying something. We're going to end that battle. All right, a one-on-one run. One more battle. I'm just curious. We know the baddest of all the Dowie against large armored targets are the Giant Slayers. Let's see how these Giant Slayers do up against these Empire Knights. Let's see what they are going to accomplish. All right, we'll get them. And let's start that fight. Here we go. And they're going to chew these Empire Knights up. Because they are armor-piercing anti-large. They are absolute killers. Boom. Alright. How many kills did the Giant Slayers got? Remember, I mean the Empire Knights against the Giant Slayers. Giant Slayers are slightly less than half health. And 11 kills is what they got against our Longbeards with great weapons. 13 against these Giant Slayers. So, these Giant Slayers at 1250 didn't do as good as our Longbeards at 750, which really did maybe slightly better than our two Miners at 650. So, is there something to this? You better believe there's something to this. You know, I can already look at, you know, if we want to look at a Dowie build, I'll just give like a basic Dowie build. We'll go, you know, with a Master Rune of Wrath and Ruin, that's kind of like what you want. And you get yourself a Runesmith, and you give him the Rune of Wrath and Ruin, and you give him the Hammer of Karak Draws. You know, that's your heroes. You're going to want maybe a couple Dwarf Warriors for your edges. You're going to want a couple Longbeards at some place. You know, ranked up one, and you're going to want maybe a couple Bugman's Rangers for kind of, this is a base build. Now, if we look at a base build, you know, I could definitely see us giving ourselves a couple of Longbeards with great weapons to defend against Cav and a couple of miners. Now you could even replace those two miners with blasting charges. Use your blasting charges in the front line and then send your miners with blasting charges to the back line. But this is now sort of your basic lineup. You know, where if you want to fill out your front line, you know, maybe we get, you know, a couple thunders, and maybe we get a couple of hammers for that front line, and we got 1,000 left. You know, maybe we get a couple more dwarf warriors, and that's, you know, we can do some ranking up, but that's a pretty solid Dowie build, where really the longbeards with great weapons and these miners are not for the front line at all. They're for that back line. And I mean, we could do this so many ways, you know, or you take these guys out, you want a little bit of mobility, you can put in a couple of gyrocopters, whatever you want for your base, sort of base build. But I honestly think that a Dowie, if we just look at the base infantry build for the Dowie, something like this is going to do well for almost every build. You know, you can fill out with 5 longbeards and stuff like that, but really the miners and the miners with blasting charges, if you use their blasting charges in the front and then you bring around back, this is your anti-cav, your cheap anti-cav, your cheap Dowie anti-cav. They're your spearmen and your halberdiers. At least that sure is what it looks like to me. And I just want to say thanks to Captain Beardy. Amazing observation that, you know, most cav do have very low melee defense, and even most, like, you know, these guys are at 28, some of these guys are more, it's like 28 for these guys, some are more 36, and even if you go and look at, chariots, you know, these chariots are 28, Gorby's chariots 32, that is really some sort of find for the Dowie, and something I'm going to do some more testing on. So thank you, Captain Beardy. Awesome find. Very interesting. And I have a lot of testing to do. And some builds to make better. Are these builds going to be better than even having Slayers in your back line? I don't know. Maybe not the Dragonback Slayers because I have a slow. But boy, oh boy. They're going to tar pit things in your back line real well. I don't know. Extremely interesting. And definitely is going to lead to some new builds. Fascinating stuff. Thank you again. Hope you guys found that interesting. Look forward to seeing some comments down below. What do you think about this as your anti-cav contingent? Not using your longbeards with great weapons, not using your miners with great miners, or even your dwarf warriors with great weapons. Really, you can use them in the back line too, but really this is your anti-cav. And using your regular longbeards for the front line to hold off. What do you think? I think the testing is going to prove out. I think it's going to show that what we think is true and what Captain Beardy has suggested. Maybe this is what the Dowie is meant to use as anti-cav. Now I get it. Someone who's really good at cycle charging is going to eat up some miners. But if they forget them for even a second or they get tangled up, that could be really devastating. So I've been playing this a long time. I've tested so many things, but I've never really tested miners against cav, because why would you? So thanks, Captain Beardy. We have some great new builds on the way. We have some more testing on the way. I hope there's some Dowie players out here that are going to try and put this into use as well, into their builds, into their game. You know, sort of a backline like this, a couple miners, a couple longbeards with great weapons to deal with Bretonian cav, Empire cav, you know, Chaos cav, chariots, these types of things, rather than the really ultra expensive Giant Slayers. Really? That's, you know, 1250. Very, very expensive. They're awesome. But they're expensive, and you saw how the Longbeards did, and that wasn't even taking the charge. They just straight up went and fought. So some more testing to come. Thank you very much. Want to hear from everyone. Look forward to the comments down below, and I will see you soon.